seen your voice recital here on Facebook. We're so happy that you could be joining us from everywhere all over the world and all over the United States, which is really awesome. So we're going to get started in a few minutes. We just want to let some people jump on here first before we start singing. But I thought I'd take a second to ask Rhea a couple questions. So say hi, everybody.
Hi.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining.
Yeah. So Rhea, where do you currently go to school?
I go to Moon Area High School.
Yeah, and now you're officially graduated, is that correct?
Yes.
And where will you be attending school in the fall?
The Ohio State University.
Nice, what are you going to major in?
Neuroscience and pre-med.
Awesome, that is fantastic. So Rhea today is going to share a plethora of beautiful music of all genres. We're going to hear some jazz, we're going to hear some beautiful classical music by Monteverdi, we're also going to hear some pieces from musical theater, as well as Krish is going to make an appearance and play for us. And then Rhea is going to accompany herself on the piano and sing some pop songs as well as a musical theater piece as well. So I'm just going to go over and check and see if we got some viewers and then that we can get started. All right. Yeah, we got about 9-ish people on here so far. Do we want to wait a couple minutes? Okay. We're gonna wait just a little bit. How's everybody doing? Say hi, Rhea. Say hi to Rhea.
Hi.
Hi. Fantastic. Oh, my mom's watching. Hi, Mom. Wonderful. Rhea, can you tell us what your favorite subject was in school throughout your years? Can you?
Probably bio. And like other sciences.
Yeah.
I liked bio and anatomy. And yeah. And I also liked Gov a lot, which is kind of different. But yeah, AP Gov, that was one of my favorite classes.
That is different. Who was your favorite teacher? Do you have one off the top of your head?
Yeah, Mr. Duramo, he was my Gov teacher.
Aw, that's awesome. Yeah. Mr. Duramo's so fantastic. Yeah. lovely. He is very great. Do you have a favorite memory from high school?
I did like the chorus trip we went on my freshman year because that was like our last year with Miss Cole, and then like also we got to meet Miss J that year. But it was our trip to Disney that was really fun. We had that freshman year, and like I met a lot of my friends since I like just moved, so that was fun.
Yeah.
I really liked that, and then I did also enjoy the shows. I think Green Room right before opening night was always like such a great memory for me. So that definitely. And then probably just recently when we had the drive through to pick up our diploma, that was fun because I got to see like all the teachers standing, even though like everything was crazy this year. But yeah, that was probably good.
Yeah, that's so lovely. I got to see some of that on Facebook. I was like, what a clever idea.
Yeah.
Like, to celebrate. Wonderful. Well, Rhea, why don't we get started with our first selection, which is Fly Me to the Moon.
Thank you.
Krish's piano instructor for quite some time now that they're here in beautiful Moon Township in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. It's kind of overcast here, but very muggy, so hopefully we'll have a better day. But Rhea, why are these jazz pieces so special to you?
I think definitely because there was something I've never tried before, because even before I moved here, most of you all know that I've been singing for a long time, but it's definitely always been pop and musical theater. So jazz really brought me out of my comfort zone, especially with these two pieces, because in the next one, Summertime, you'll hear me scatting, which is like all improvisations, and I kind of do it differently every time, which is pretty special because it's not actually like written in the music. And so that was definitely me jumping out of my comfort zone, which is special to me because, you know, it shows growth as a musician. And I also was in the jazz choir for a couple of years with Miss J at Moon Area High School.
Yeah, awesome. So our next selection is Summertime by Gershwin. By Claudia Monteverdi, and this is a classical piece. So I know that you singing voice. Can you tell us a little bit about your vocal study journey and when you started taking lessons and where?
Yeah, so I started taking lessons with a lady named Sheena at Fairlawn School of Music. That's where I started. And I think I was in fifth or sixth grade, so quite a while ago. And then after a couple years with her, I started studying under Helen Welsh, and she was also at Fairlawn School of Music. And I did significantly different things with each of them. And then we ended up moving here, and I started with you.
Me!
And I've been with her for 4 years now. And yeah, it's been super long.
I know! Yeah. I can't believe it!
Yeah.
4 years flew.
And we've done a lot of different pieces. And for like example, like she said, we are doing classical one next. And so that also, just like the jazz, brings me out of my comfort zone because it's not my standard singing. So hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, this piece is in Italian, and Lasciatemi Morire, it's a kind of a song about, it's very sad, so if you can get that overall feeling from this. So go ahead, Rhea, whenever you're ready.
That was my first show I've ever done because at Revere, my old school, we didn't have like middle school musical theater. So that was definitely a big step for me singing-wise because it's very different than like singing by yourself and being in a musical and everything. And yeah, that was Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and I played one of the grandmas.
Oh my gosh, you are so funny! Oh, I wish all of you could have been there. It was so funny.
Yeah, and I also played a squirrel. that was definitely really fun. I met some of my best friends there, and they're still my best friends today, and so I'm very thankful for that. And yeah, shout out to Mr. Michael and Ms. Mitchell for being such great coordinators and directors of the theater program, and Ms. J for being such a great musical director of the theater program. So after sophomore year, I did them. Oh, I also did, also sophomore year for the spring musical, I did Wizard of Oz. And in Wizard of Oz, I was just kind of like one of the ensemble characters. Mm-hmm. And I was also, I forget the official name, but I was the one girl who like gave the lollipops during the Munchkin Man song. That was also, I think that was definitely my favorite show because like I said, I'm really close with a lot of the, they're now, oh my gosh, they're now going to be juniors in college. Oh, that's crazy. But yeah, like again, they're some of my best friends and I met some of my really good friends during that show. So I'm very thankful for them. And so that was definitely my favorite show. And then junior year, I did Elf and I was Deb. And I think that was definitely my favorite role because I think I'm pretty Deb-like if you've ever seen Elf. And so, yeah, I love that show for sure. So that's the shows that I've done in high school.
Wonderful. So this next selection is a very famous piece and such a fun piece. This is Don't Rain on My Parade from Funny Girl.
Don't tell me not to fly, have simply
from Hamilton. And this guy has a special place in your heart, especially because this is one that you competed with at the National Association of Teachers of Singing competition this past fall, which I thought was really great. It was a pretty fun time to have you all sing. And I know this is a favorite show. Have you seen the show yet?
Yes, I have seen Hamilton in Pittsburgh. It was definitely one of the best shows I've ever seen. It was amazing. I don't know if my mom would agree because she fell asleep, but...
I agree!
But she liked it.
It
was such an amazing show, and I really like Hamilton in general, especially like I was talking about kind of like I like Gov and AP US history, so I like follow the story. It's about Alexander Hamilton, and so I don't know if you know anything about him, but this song is about when Eliza, his wife, found out that he was cheating on her, and so it's a pretty moving piece, but yeah, I really like this song.
Rhea, if you want to grab your music, and I'm going to take this. And Chris, whenever I can bring the camera around, we can get started. I'll give you a good old cue. Okay, everyone, we're going on an adventure. And Krish, what are you playing for us today?
Basement Mucho by Wonderful. Andrea Bocelli.
Wonderful. Whenever you're ready. Turn some pages. So we're going to get Rhea set up because she is now going to play. Rhea, how long have you been playing piano for?
Very long time. I think since I was 6 or 7.
Oh my goodness.
And I studied under two amazing pianists, Miss Trisha Thompson and Mr. Tetsuya Nagashima.
Wonderful. And where did you study with them at?
Akron, Ohio. Okay. And then whenever I moved here, I didn't take any more lessons, but I continued to play with this amazing piano we have in our house.
Yeah, wonderful. How's that? Does that feel good?
Yes.
Fantastic. So this next selection is For Forever from Dear Evan Hansen. Is there anything you want to say about this piece?
Yes, I love this piece. I actually saw it with my mom this year on my birthday in New York City right before everything started, so that was an amazing opportunity. We got to see that. It was amazing. Mm-hmm. And I also want to dedicate this to my friend Alana. She's been my best friend since like second or third grade now in Ohio, and I'm really thankful that I've been able to maintain my friendship with her. And this song is about friendship and about always at your lowest point, you always have somebody who's going to bring you up, and that's always been Alana for me. So I want to say thank you, Alana, and that I love you. And this is For Forever from Dear Evan Hansen.
Thank you.
song is When We Were Young by Adele. Is there anything special about this song, Rhea, that you want to mention?
I love Adele.
Yes.
And actually, I want to dedicate this to Anisha, my cousin, because she also shares love of Adele with me, and I love always singing with her at our reunions at Thanksgiving, and so this is for her and for the whole Desai family. Everybody watching, and for everyone who will be watching soon on the video that's going to be saved. But I really could not be here without all of you, and I'm so thankful to know all of you and to have an influence like you guys in my life. And then I would also like to thank Lauren, my teacher, because I have been so thankful to be your student and your friend for the past couple years. And you have been such an inspiration, and I know that you will do amazing things in the future.
Thank you.
And then,
thank you, Lauren.
Yes, thank you. And then lastly, I want to thank my family and also Miss Nan for being a great pianist, for being a gracious teacher, and for doing such a lovely job here, especially on Don't Rain on My Parade. That was an amazing song.
Yes, thank you, Kelly.
Yeah, and lastly, my family, because I really could not see myself where I am. They've paid for my lessons, my schooling, have always supported all of my dreams, and continue to, and I will greatly miss them in college, but I'm very thankful for where I am today. And I would not be here without all of them. And I would like to dedicate this last song, Like I'm Gonna Lose You, to them, because this has always been a song that's been really special to me and to my whole family. I've been playing this song for years and years now, and it's kind of like my signature song. I bet you guys have all heard me play and sing this, but kind of like a last one, I like to play and sing this. So this is Like I'm Gonna Lose You by Meghan Trainor and John Legend.